Hello everyone, welcome back to Engineering Online. In this video we will learn about the interfacing of a 4x4 keypad with Arduino Uno. Keypad is used widely all over the world to interact with embedded devices. It is one of the most important input devices. It is quite easiest and cheapest method to send commands to electronic system. Let's first have a quick introduction of keypads. Keypad is nothing but 16 push buttons are arranged in the form of an array. It has 4 rows and 4 columns. There are two types of keypads available, that is 3x4 size and 4x4 size. Keypad is mainly used when you have to load numeric inputs to the controller. Keypads are quite thin and they can easily be mounted anywhere they are needed. They are used almost in every engineering project. If you even look around, you will find keypad in many electronic appliances. For example, a simple ATM machine has a keypad on it. Similarly, calculator also has a keypad on it. So in short, there are numerous applications of keypad. Keypad uses metric system in order to work. I am using a 4x4 keypad, so there are total 12 buttons on it. It will have total 8 pins, 4 pins for rows and 4 pins for column. Columns and rows are connected with each other. Now suppose I press button 1 on the keypad, then first row and first column will get short and I will get to know that button 1 is pressed. Same is the case with other buttons. For example, I press button 8, then second column and third row will get short, so this code will remain unique for each button. Quite simple, isn't it? Let's have a look at how to interface this keypad with Arduino Uno. I have labeled the 8 pins of keypad from 1 to 8. Now connect the first pin of keypad to digital pin 2 of Arduino Uno. Then connect pin 2 of keypad to pin 3 of Arduino Uno. In this way, connect all 8 pins of keypad to Arduino digital pins from 2 to 9. Now I will follow the same procedure in hardware implementation also. Once you are done with the hardware connections, let's write program in Arduino IDE. Before writing program, you have to download keypad library. So, first go to sketch and then include library. And make sure that no library is already installed for the keypad. Now press manage libraries and search for the keypad library in the library manager search bar. There is a library for matrix style keypads. Now install it. Press the install button and once it is installed completely, close it. Now you will find the keypad library under contributed libraries section. Click on it and keypad library header would be added in the code already. Now first I am defining two constants named as rows and columns. And their value is set to 4 since there are 4 rows and 4 columns. Next, I am defining a 4x4 character array and adding line and adding elements in it same as are present on the keypad. Now I am defining two arrays to show that which Arduino pins are connected to row pinouts of the keypad and which pins are connected to the column pinouts of the keypad. In the next line, I am initiating an instance of class keypad. Name of the object is keypad. Call the keypad function. It has 4 attributes, that is make key map, row pins, column pins, rows and columns. Since we are using serial monitor of Arduino IDE, so initialize serial transmission and set the baud rate or transmission rate of Arduino IDE to 9600. So when you will press a key on the keypad, it will take input in key variable and then that key would be printed on the serial monitor. Coding is complete now. Now compile it and correct if there are any syntax errors. After successful compilation, upload the sketch on Arduino Uno and see the results on serial monitor. I am pressing the keypad buttons and I can see the same digit appearing on the serial monitor. It shows that we have successfully interfaced a 4x4 keypad with Arduino Uno. Now try it on your own and provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. I hope that you must have learned from this video. You can do many more exciting projects with keypad and Arduino interfacing. That was all for today. Do like this video and share with your friends. Subscribe to our channel for more interesting and informative videos. Thank you.